Hello everyone.
Welcome to our experience center. This is Ranjani from Intech Systems. I am here to explain about Industry 4.0 and we have live demo setup for traceability solution in our experience center. So let's get to know about Industry 4.0. It is a current trend in all industries and it is nothing but a real-time digital transformation of production data to cloud. It is also known as IIoT, which is Industrial Internet of Things. So why do we need to have real-time data? Let's all consider a manufacturing industry for an example. There will be a lots of production and assembly process in their plants, and different types of small and large components will be involved to produce a single product. So there are many possibilities for operator to make a mistake during a process. For example, they can miss some component to assemble, or a defective and wrong component can also be assembled in a product. So as a result, a defective component will reach their customer, which leads to a customer dissatisfaction and business loss. And most importantly, brand image will be spoiled. And it is not very easy to trace where the mistake was happened and who is the responsible one. In this place, Industry 4.0 plays a vital role to avoid such situations, and it traces all the processes from raw material procurement to production, assembly and dispatch to customer, and logs all these data in cloud for our future reference. So we can have information like where and when the product was produced, and who is the operator, who have approved the product, and what are the components assembled, what is the temperature maintained, and etc. So all those data will be logged in cloud and can be viewed in daily and monthly report. Not only recording the data, we can also reject the defective product during the process itself, which prevents a defective product reach their customer. So now let us see how it can be done in industries. This is our experience center. Here we have a demo setup for traceability solution, IO links with EtherCAT IO modules, and safety solution, vision solution, motion control solution, that is VFT and servers, and finally robot and cobot solutions. So let us see the overview of its functioning. First, we will see about traceability solution. Here we have set up a 5 slave stations and 1 master station. In each station, we are using different brands of PLCs and HMIs, and they are all connected through a common communication medium Ethernet and connected with Omron NJ controller. So in first station, we have Mitsubishi PLC and HMI. In this station, Honeywell barcode printer is connected with a Mitsubishi PLC. It is a thermal barcode printer and have RS-232 communication to connect with PLC. In this station, the operator have to select the model of the product to be manufactured. Here we have 10 number of models, and these models will be fetched from the server. So when I select the particular model, the corresponding QR code will be printed using this Honeywell printer. QR code will contain the information of date, time and model number. We can also customize this data as per our requirement. In second station, we are using Siemens PLC and HMI along with Omron barcode reader. Okay, so in this station, we will start with scanning the QR code, which is printed in the first station. So if the previous station data is okay, then only we will proceed with the next process. Otherwise, we will reject the product and send back to rework. The same process will be followed in station 3 also. So in this station, we have Delta PLC and HMI along with Omron barcode reader. And we have Epson thermal printer connected with Delta HMI. This is one of the main advantage of Delta HMI, to which we can directly connect the printer, so that there is no need to do any additional program for printer in PLC. In fourth station, we are using Omron PLC and HMI. And in this station, we have basic type Omron vision camera. The vision system is mainly used for visual quality inspection. Using vision camera, we can check the presence of small components, color and shape of the product, and we can do measurement and code reading applications. So here we are reading OCR and QR code and transfer the data to PLC. And the PLC will transfer the data to Omron NJ controller and check with the server. When the previous station data are okay, then only we will proceed with the next process. The fifth station is weighing station. Here we have a load cell and weighing meter connected with AB PLC. And in this station, we have a MTV, which is nothing but a machine TV interface. This is used to connect a monitor with PLCs, and this will convert the program logic into machine language. So we can use a large size display as a HMI, and its programming is also similar to HMI programming. We are considering this as a final station and all the processes are completed, and we are taking the weight of the product and we have set a target value as 2000. When the weight of the product is matches with the target value, then it will be qualified and dispatched to customer. This is our master station. Here we are using Omron NJ controller and it is connected with PC in which we have installed SQL Server. The Omron NJ controller is capable of connecting with the DB using any interface. So it can be communicated with SQL Server, MySQL, Oracle and etc. This VLC will collect all data from every slave station and transfer them to cloud. And in every station, it will compare the current station data with previous station data and gives the result accordingly. And finally, all the station data will be logged in cloud, so we can get daily and monthly report. And we can also get report in Excel format and can send mail to a concerned person. So this is how the traceability works. Now we will move on to remote I/O stations. So what is remote I/Os? The I/O module is nothing but input and output modules to which we will connect the sensors and actuators. The term remote I/O refers the I/O modules is installed in the distant place from the main PLC. Because in industries, it is not possible to have field devices near the main control PLC. So we need a remote I/O modules. So with this remote I/O modules, the signals can be received from far away sensors and the control signals can be sent to long distance to control valves, motors and other final actuators. Here we are using Omron EtherCAT coupler, which is connected with I/O modules and communicated with Omron NJ PLC through Ethernet communication. And this will eliminate the complexity of wiring and assures faster communications. In our experience center, we have connected I/O-Link sensors with these I/O modules. And the I/O-Link sensors are intelligent type sensors and it will give process data as well as sensor information like output signal quality, sensor temperature and sensor running time. Whereas the normal sensors only gives on or off signal. And these sensors will do self-monitoring and gives its status along with its serial number to I/O-Link master device. So that in case of errors, we can easily locate the faulty sensor instead of checking all the connected sensors in the field. Predictive maintenance is also possible with these sensors since it gives remaining running hours of the sensor. So we can replace them before it getting failure without affecting the protection. And these sensors have standard 3-wire type connection like non-I/O-Link sensors. So it can be connected with standard I/O modules also. But while connecting with I/O-Link master device, it will act as a I/O-Link sensor. In our experience center, we have connected I/O-Link photoelectric sensor, proximity sensor and displacement sensor and displays their values in HMI through communication. Next, we will see about safety solution. So what is the need for safety devices? As we know, the machines and robots will also be working in industries. And they will be dangerous to human beings. So they should be isolated from them or in off condition when a human enters their workspace. So for that purpose, we need safety devices. There are lots of safety devices are available in the market like a safety light curtain, safety scanner, safety door lock switch and safety mat and etc. And the majorly used safety devices in industries are safety scanner and light curtain. So we will see about the functionalities of light curtain and safety scanner in this video. Before that, we will see about safety over EtherCAT function, which is being implemented in our experience center using Omron safety controller, to which we have connected Omron safety light curtain and safety scanner. The safety over EtherCAT is mainly introduced to use the single communication medium for both control and safety data. So instead of connecting safety devices with the control PLC, we will connect them with Omron safety controller, which supports safety over EtherCAT protocol. And the safety data will be transferred to the control PLC through EtherCAT communication for further process. And the safety interlock logic will be developed in the safety controller itself so that we can get a faster response. If you do the safety interlock logic in the main control PLC, then there might be some delay in taking immediate actions due to the execution time and process of the PLC since it has to scan the entire program for each cycle. But this will not happen when we do the logic in safety controller because only the safety data will be transferred to the main PLC as an interrupt input so that immediate action can be taken and the machine will be stopped without any delay. As I already mentioned, we have connected safety light curtain and safety area scanner with the Omron safety controller. Let us see their function in detail. The light curtain will basically act as an electronic fence in industries, and it will have one transmitter and receiver. The transmitter will transmit the parallel infrared light beam to receiver unit. When an object interrupts one or more beams, then the control logic of the light curtain will stop the machine immediately and avoid the accident. The next one is safety scanner, which is usually an area scanner, and it uses laser beams to monitor the working area of machines or robots. When an object or human being interrupts in this working area, then it will get reflected beams and stops the machine immediately. It will cover 270 degree area up to 15 meter. We can also customize the safety zone using the programming software. Next, we will see about advanced vision system. This is high speed, high accuracy vision controller to which we can connect up to 8 cameras. As I already said, vision is mainly used for visual inspection, and with this controller we can do convoy tracking and defect identification applications which cannot be done in basic vision camera. And we can share real time images to server with the customized folder name. And it have high speed communication protocols like EtherCAT, Ethernet and Profinet to communicate with PLCs and robots. The next is VFD and servo station. Here we have Mitsubishi, Omron and Delta VFDs. The two Delta VFDs are being used for energy saving concept using DC bus sharing method. And the DC bus of both the VFDs are connected in parallel. During regeneration, the motor will act as a generator and produces energy and send back to VFD. This action causes rise in DC bus voltage, and in DC bus sharing method, this excess voltage is shared to another VFD which drives a motor. This also reduces the power drawn from the mains. And we are using 5 axis of Omron servo drives with EtherCAT communication protocol. From this, 2 servo axes are used for synchronous function and 3 servo axes are used for ECAM function. The synchronous function is used to drive the 2 axis of servo motor in same speed and in same direction. And the other 3 servos are used for flying shear or cutting concept, where the knife and the product to be moved in synchronous speed to achieve precise cutting and have reduced cycle time. And this is achieved by the ECAM function of the Omron servo drive. Next, we will see about robot and cobot solutions. Here we have Mitsubishi Scara robot and Omron articulated cobot. The Scara robot has 600 mm reach and 6 kg payload, and it can be used for high speed pick and place operations and repeated processes like soldering and screwing, where the production rate is a main constraint. And we have Omron cobot with 1300 mm reach and 12 kg payload. The cobot is nothing but collaborative robot, and it is mainly designed to work along with people without causing any damage, as it will stop operating when it hit by an external object or a human being. There is no need to use additional safety devices. And in Omron cobot, we have inbuilt vision camera using which we can check the orientation and shape of the product, and code reading is also possible with this camera. Hope this video is very useful and informative. Please do visit our experience center for better understanding. Thanks for watching.